why is my down there, my bikini line area, brown or darker than my regular skin tone? How do you remove hair down there? Is it important to shave the inside? Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. So the other day I asked you on Instagram to ask me all of your TMI, feminine hygiene, girl talk questions that you are too afraid to ask your mom, and you guys definitely delivered with the questions. So in this video, I'm gonna be answering all of them. And just a heads up, I already know this is definitely going to be the most TMI that I've ever been on my channel, so just be prepared. If you're not interested in seeing that type of content, just click out of this video. But if you enjoyed this video, please let me know in the comments below, because I would love to make this a series. And you can also ask me any other questions that you have that I did not address or answer in this video for my next questions that you're too afraid to ask your mom video. Now, before we get into the questions, I do just want to thank Uqora for kindly sponsoring this video. So Uqora is a brand that's focused on promoting a healthy urinary system with their urinary tract health supplements. And that is definitely something important to stay on top of. We all know how annoying UTIs can be and how painful they can be. Yes, I've had multiple and they are not fun. So if you have not had any before, consider yourself lucky. One of the founders of Uqora, Jenna Ryan, actually experienced 8 UTIs in 1 year, which sounds horrendous. That's like almost 1 a month. I cannot even imagine that. And that is what inspired her to start Uqora. And I actually just found this out recently, but UTIs are the second most common infection in the United States, second to the common cold. And also they result in 10 million visits to the doctor's office every year. Now we all know the trick of drinking cranberry juice. I don't know about you, but I would just go to the grocery store and try to get the most pure cranberry juice. And it would taste disgusting, but sometimes that's not enough, and neither is peeing after sex. So instead, I've started to take Uqora's complete system to help promote urinary health. So there are 3 products that come in Uqora's complete system. You have Target, which flushes the urinary tract. You have Control, which cleanses your biofilm. And then you also have Promote to balance your vaginal microbiome. So you just take 1 capsule of Promote daily, 2 capsules of Control daily, and 1 packet of Target after sex or every 3 days. The reason why I like Uqora's complete system so much is because it helps to protect you from all angles. So not only does it help to promote the health of your urinary system, but also your vaginal microbiome and your biofilm. Which, by the way, I actually had to look up what a biofilm was, and basically it is a community of bacteria that's covered in protective goo. And yeah, it sounds gross, but it's responsible for recurrent UTIs. So Uqora's complete system helps to cleanse your body of those. Jenna Ryan and her partner Spencer actually worked together with physicians and urologists to make Uqora's complete system. So this is not a cranberry supplement. Yes, the products are made with science-backed ingredients. With Uqora, you get free shipping and fast delivery. Usually it takes just about 4 days. You can also subscribe to their products and you'll save 35% off your order. And the amazing thing is that they have a money back guarantee, no questions asked. So yes, you can get a full refund if you need it. And if you have any questions along the way about your supplements or anything else related to Uqora, their customer service is easily accessible and they will be there to answer all of your questions. So once again, thank you to Uqora for sponsoring this video and supporting my channel. And now let's get into all of your girl talk questions that you are too afraid to ask your mom. So by far the most asked question was, why is my down there, my bikini line area, brown or darker than my regular skin tone? So the reason for this is hormones. Basically, as you get older, your hormones shift and your down there can actually change color, and it can turn darker, it can turn brown, even like a little bit purplish brown, but it is completely normal. And it's actually more common in women with darker skin tones and less common in women with lighter skin tones. And I have some anecdotal evidence of how how this has impacted me. So when I was pregnant and before I was pregnant, I did have this, I don't want to say issue because like I don't consider it an issue because it's completely natural, but I did have a darker down there area. And now postpartum, it's not dark anymore. It's like pink. So I was reading online, like some articles will suggest that friction in between your underwear can cause skin darkening down there, or sweat can cause skin darkening down there. I really do think it's mainly hormones. And because of that, the next question that a lot of you guys asked was how to lighten that area. Now, because I personally think that it is mainly caused by hormones, I don't want to sit here and give you some like crazy DIY recipe to help lighten down there when I truly don't think that that is really possible or healthy to do, because I think it's mainly caused by your hormones. Having said that, yes, there are creams that you can use to help lighten down there. I don't condone using those creams whatsoever because I don't think it's healthy to put chemicals like that down there at all. Another thing that you could try just on your bikini line, not on your actual like down there area, is you could exfoliate. So over the summer when I was pregnant, I had super dark underarms. And it was also caused by hormones from being pregnant. I did exfoliate my armpits heavily and it helped to lighten them somewhat, so you could try that. I also did like an armpit steam and that helped to lighten them a little bit. So you could also take like a super hot shower and the steam from the shower may help to lighten your bikini line. But all in all, I really don't think that there's much you can do to alter the color. I think it is what it is. You have to learn to love and accept yourself. That sounded so corny, but it's the truth. Okay, so the next question that I got asked so much was, how do you remove hair down there? So there are three ways to remove hair down there. You can wax, you can shave, you can do laser. So I personally shave. And the reason why I shave is because it's more convenient for me. I don't have to go to the salon. I can do it whenever I want in the comfort of my own home. The idea of waxing just kind of freaks me out because I don't want some random person looking down there. It's not worth it for me. However, although I do shave down there, there are definitely some cons to shaving. So first of all, the regrowth, a lot of the time, yes, it is super itchy. Also, if I go too long without shaving, then when I do shave, I can sometimes get ingrown hairs. And usually the regrowth will be even itchier. Sometimes I'll get bumps and there's really nothing I can do if I have gone a long time in between shaving. So I really try to shave like once every 2 to 3 weeks. If I go over a month, the regrowth will be insanely itchy. Now the pros to waxing, first of all, your bikini line area, your down there area is gonna be so smooth. Another pro is that the hair is gonna take a lot longer to grow back. And then one con of waxing is that it freaking hurts. I sometimes flinch when I get my eyebrows waxed. I cannot even imagine getting down there waxed. I think I would cry. So with laser, I really don't know much about laser. I do know that it's really expensive, but of course, the results are allegedly permanent. I have heard that some people have actually experienced their hair growing back after getting laser. So I cannot say for sure if like your hair will be gone forever. Those are your options. The next question is super TMI, but someone asked, is it important to shave the inside? And the answer is, first of all, do whatever you want. If it makes you happy, do it. Don't do it for someone else, do it for yourself. But they also asked if I do, so I try to, but for some reason, it's just really hard for me to get all the hairs there. So I'm always left with a little bit of stubble, and I don't know why it's so hard for me to shave like the inside area. Maybe the hairs grow at a weird angle or something, or maybe like I can't really see that well down there. I don't really know, but it's just always been that way. If you guys are wondering, like I'm obviously not talking about shaving inside of your area. I'm talking about shaving like within the lips. All right, so the next question that I'm gonna address is, why is that area super moist and icky after I've shaved, I don't like it. So that was the question. And my answer is that clearly we don't like pubic hair. It's annoying. And obviously you guys had a lot of questions about shaving. So there you go. Pubic hair, no me gusta. Having said that, it's there for a reason. So the reason why it's there evolutionarily is because it protects the area from any foreign bacteria that may be coming in. So it would just like, you know, get in the hair, get stuck and not infect your area. Similarly, if you are sweating, the hair is going to capture it and it's not going to go inside. And you're also probably not going to feel it as much because you can't feel really what's on your hair, just what's on your skin. So when you shave or when you remove the hair from down there, you no longer have anything protecting it. So whatever's touching it, you are going to be able to feel completely. And that's why you feel moist. You may have been moist, oh, it's so weird to say, before you shaved, but you would not have felt it because the hair caught all of it. So that's why. So the next question was, how do you prevent cysts and razor bumps down there? So the main way that I would suggest you to prevent cysts and razor bumps is to make sure that you are always cleaning the area thoroughly and also drying that area thoroughly. So if, for example, you frequently shave down there, it's going to be really easy for bacteria to get in the hair follicle and that can create a bump or a cyst. So make sure that the area is just always kept dry. You can wear cotton underwear that's moisture wicking. So it is just going to capture a lot of the moisture from down there and it won't leave it as much on your skin. Another way to prevent getting razor bumps, ingrown hairs, cysts, and stuff like that down there is just to make sure that you're shaving on a semi-regular basis. The thing with shaving and razor bumps is that, from my experience, if I shave too often, it's a disaster. I will probably bleed and I will definitely get razor bumps because I'm just shaving really short stubble. Similarly, if I wait too long to shave, then I will get ingrown hairs and that will cause bumps and sometimes cysts down there just because I had let the hair grow for so long. The best way to go about it, I found, is just every 2 weeks to shave. And obviously everyone's hair grows at a different rate. Don't shave too often, but make sure that you're shaving enough so that it doesn't grow into like a huge bush if you want to avoid cysts and razor bumps. So the next question that someone asked is, what are some reasons down there might smell? So I just want to cover like one of the main reasons that it could smell that could actually be an issue. And that is an infection called bacterial vaginosis or vaginitis. So as I have said before, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a gynecologist, so I'm not gonna like diagnose anyone. But sometimes if you do have a really strong smell down there, it could be that infection. And don't be embarrassed, it is super common, but that is one culprit of a weird smell down there. Another culprit could be if you are on your period or if you're approaching your period. Sometimes like you get a different scent down there, and then also, not to be like too gross, but what am I saying? This video is so TMI. Sometimes like the blood doesn't have the best smell. So when you're on your period, it can smell weird down there. Just make sure that you're cleaning yourself. Also, maybe just like if you're not changing your underwear enough, but I hope that that's a given that you should be doing that. If you're not cleaning yourself well enough, again, I hope that that's a given. Those are some reasons why it may smell. One of the other questions was, how do you smell good down there? So one of the main ways to smell good down there, as I had already said, is to make sure that you're cleaning yourself. So you want to make sure that you are thoroughly wiping, that you're thoroughly cleaning yourself in the shower. So another way to smell good down there is to make sure that you are having protected sex, because a lot of STDs can make you smell bad down there. And I hope that you guys are not motivated to have protected sex because you don't want to smell bad down there. The main thing that you should be motivated by is avoiding an STD just in general. Just know that smelling bad down there is a symptom of some STDs. Also, make sure that you're practicing good hygiene because that can help to prevent bacterial vaginosis. And also just make sure that, again, you're having protected sex because that can also help to prevent bacterial vaginosis. I say it like it's this like a beautiful thing. So the next question that someone asked is, how long after I gave birth did I bleed for? So I bled for 6 weeks. It was not fun. Obviously, it could be much worse. Like, I think some people bleed for longer than that, but 6 weeks was enough for me. And I know that this wasn't one of the questions asked, but I might as well just say it now that we're on the topic of bleeding and postpartum. So I'm 9 weeks postpartum, or I was 9 weeks postpartum yesterday, and I got my period yesterday. And I am exclusively breastfeeding. So I have no idea how that happened. I know when you're breastfeeding, you usually go without a period for a long time, but there are some women who just get a period like regular after they give birth. And I am one of those women, of course, you know, just right back on my period and breastfeeding and just dealing with a postpartum body. I am just like, gonna be honest, I'm kind of struggling right now. The next question is, how do you stay clean down there during your period? So I have this amazing product that I want to share with you guys. This is called a peri bottle. And these are mainly marketed towards postpartum women, but I am featuring it in this video because I have no idea why it is not marketed also towards women who are on their period. And this is because when I was postpartum, I would use this anytime I would go to the bathroom. So basically you fill it up with warm water, and then after you're done going to the bathroom, you just squeeze it. It's really easy to squeeze, and then water shoots up and it cleans your down there area. And what I found is not only does it clean the area, but also it helps you get rid of a lot of the blood. So any blood that you have just like down there that the toilet paper didn't get off, this will help to rinse it off. So there's not nearly as much blood on the pad as there was before I would use the peri bottle. So I still use this every time I go to the bathroom. And that is how I stay clean down there during my period now. So this is by Freedom Mom, I believe, and I'll link it below. This is a lifesaver. You could also use this if you're not on your period. I don't know. I'm in love with this. It's such a weird thing to say that I'm in love with a peri bottle. Also, just making sure that you're showering. I'm gonna be completely honest. Sometimes I shower twice a day when I'm on my period, if it's that kind of period. So another question that I got asked is body hair a turnoff for guys? First of all, I want to say that I don't want you guys to care if it's a turnoff for guys, whether it is or it isn't, which I will address in a second. I hope that just doesn't matter. Obviously, being realistic here, sometimes we're all like concerned about what our boyfriend thinks or what guys think of us, or whoever you're attracted to, you could be concerned of what they think of you. But at the end of the day, I hope that ultimately you love yourself and you shave or don't shave for yourself and not for someone else. Having said that, from my experience with my boyfriend, he really doesn't notice my body hair. So if I've gone a long time without shaving my legs, like I did when I was pregnant, he never noticed. Same with my stomach. I do have a lot of peach fuzz on my stomach. He doesn't notice it. Same with like the hair on my upper lip, doesn't notice it. And I also just kind of feel like for guys, if you're with them, I don't think that they're gonna be like, nope, I don't wanna be with you because you're hairy. I feel like guys are just gonna be grateful that you are with them in general, in whatever way you're with them. And they're not gonna say, okay, I'm not interested in you because you're hairy. I could be wrong. I'm sure there's some people who are just like really anti-hair. Maybe they have like a phobia or something, but I feel like in general, that's not really what guys are concerned about. So the next question is, does down there sting after sex? So I think the question really is it supposed to sting? This is getting a little bit too TMI for me. So just, you know, the short answer, is it supposed to sting? No. How do you clean up down there after sex? So just take a shower. Or use a peri bottle, that easy. How do you prevent infections down there? So first of all, make sure that you are not using any perfumes or scented products down there. That is just going to mess up the pH, mess up the bacteria, and it could definitely cause an infection. Don't douche. So douching is when you clean the inside of your vagina, and that is a big no-no. That will definitely lead to an infection. Make sure that you're changing your underwear frequently. Make sure that you are using protection when you are intimate with someone. Make sure that your partner gets tested. Make sure that you get tested. Make sure that you're eating lots of yogurt that's high in probiotics, because that can help to keep the bacteria down there at a healthy level. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. Again, if you liked this video, please let me know in the comments below and I will start to make this a series. Also, thank you so much to Uqora for sponsoring this video and supporting my channel. I love all of you guys. Thank you so much for watching and I will talk to you guys next time.